इज अ पेरेंट और गार्जियन टू प्रोवाइड अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर एजुकेशन टू इस चाइल्ड और एज द केस में बी वॉर्ड बिटवीन द एज ऑफ 6 to 14 ईयर. सो वॉट इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द फंडामेंटल राइट्स डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ स्टेट पॉलिसी एंड फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज. द डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स हैव बीन यूज टू अपलोड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल वैलिडिटी ऑफ लेजिस्लेशन इन केस ऑफ अ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट विद द फंडामेंटल राइट्स. आर्टिकल 31C added by the 25th amendment in 1971 provided that any law made to give effect to directive principles in article 39 b to c would not be invalid on the grounds that they derogated from fundamental rights conferred by article 14 19 and 21. The application of the article was sought to be extended to all the directive principles by the 42nd amendment in 1946. Also, the directive principles of state policy are used for higher performance of the state. The application of this article was sought to be extended to all the directive principles by the 42nd Amendment in 1976, but the Supreme Court struck down the extension as void on the ground that it violated the basic structure of the Constitution. The fundamental rights and directive principles have also been used together in forming the basic of legislation for social welfare. The Supreme Court, after the judgment in Keshavanand Bharati case, has adopted the view of the fundamental rights and directive principles being complementary to each other, each supplementing the other's role in aiming at the same goal of establishing a welfare state by means of social revolution. Similarly, the Supreme Court has used the fundamental duties to uphold the constitutional validity of statutes which seek to promote the objectives laid out in the fundamental duties. These duties have also been held to be obligatory for all citizens, subject to the state enforcing the same by means of a valid law. The Supreme Court has also issued directions to the state in this regard with a view towards making the provision effective and enabling citizens to properly perform their duties.